Here's one of the old extractors that's armed to a place. This one's actually not too bad in terms of noise, but I thought if I'm going to place two or three air extractors, I might as well place all of them, keep them the same.
So this is what the inside of the fan looks like. So bottom left, you've got one of the things, you've got the bit here you have to poke out, like that. That's just so the cable, electricity cable, can come through here, go run along the bottom, which is crouch down. Cable comes back through here, round here, and into the junction box here. This is where the live neutral cables are. So you open this. Tricky to do one-handed. Wait, 1 second. Okay, tricky to do two-handed. So you put your cables into there. I've got three cables on the old one, so I put three cables into this one as well. They are labelled live, neutral, and LS. So easy. The timing mechanism is here. Use this screwdriver here to adjust that. Simple clockwise and anti-clockwise method. This obviously screws into the hole where the previous extractor was. There you go. So this time we're going to do it into this bathroom. I've just taken off the old extractor, so I'm going to put this into there. Let's give it a try. So here is the new air extractor on the wall. It's not currently perfectly in place yet because the previous extractor was slightly larger and the hole behind it was slightly larger, so I need to do some fixing behind the screws to do a bit of placement and fit this properly, because the screws don't fit the holes of the existing the previous air extractor. So that's a job for another day, but just so you see how it looks and sounds, here it is. So I don't know how well it's coming through on camera, but it's not silent. It's actually pretty loud. Well, loudish, you know. So in this sort of size room, got a shower. It's right there. Hopefully you're hearing how loud it is. It's more of a fan noise with wind, I guess. That's what it sounds like. Whereas in the previous one, which is more of a, it sounded more like an electrical whirry sort of sound. But if you're expecting this to be totally silent or very silent, it's not. So I was hoping it'd be a bit quieter, but it's okay. It's not louder than my previous version, which just came with the house, but I wouldn't say it's much quieter either, but it's okay. For the price, I was expecting less noise. If I was to buy again, I might go for a cheaper option, and with the cheaper option it wouldn't be that much louder, but there you go. I think it looks quite nice. It's got a blue line with a red light on it. If I turn the switch off now, which I'll show you. So down here, I've got the light switch.
And that causes this to still remain on. So the red LED on there. You can't really see on camera, it looks black on camera, but this room's dark, but I can still see the extractor quite clearly, and it's only a red light that's on. That will turn off after a certain amount of time. I'm not too sure what time it is yet, I haven't actually measured it. I can also turn it off by this, and that's turned it off straight away.
turn that back on. And turn the extractor back on. I'll just turn this on. And it comes on straight away.